Hi, ICF Kids. I hope you're having a great week with your families, playing together, helping each other, and showing God's love to each other. I hope it's been a really good week for you. Before I get into today's story, I wanted to remind you of some of the things that we've been talking about the last few weeks. 2 weeks ago, I told you about the early church and how they were devoted to God. They met together every day to praise God, learn about God, pray to God, to share with one another and remember what Jesus had done for them on the cross, and just spend time together. They were devoted to pleasing God and showing His love. Last week, Miss Elena told us about Stephen and how Stephen stood up for God even when it was very dangerous and scary for him, and how we need to stand up for God too. This week, we're going to talk about how we need to keep God number one in our life. We need to love Him with all our heart and all our soul and all our strength and all our mind. Let's look at today's story. Our story today is about Paul, and he was on his second missionary journey to go everywhere God sent him to tell people about Jesus. And he was in the city of Athens. And as he walked around the city of Athens, he saw a lot of statues and idols. Things that people had made out of metal and rock and wood, made with their own hands, just like the kids are making things out of Play-Doh. They were worshiping these things like gods. They thought that they had to keep them happy and take care of them and sacrifice to them and please them. They even had a statue that was to the unknown God because they were afraid they would miss a God that they were supposed to be worshiping. Some of the important men of the city wanted to meet with Paul and learn more about his message. So he sat and talked to them about the idols and statues that he saw around the city, and especially the one to the unknown God. He said, "I want to tell you who that God is, the God that you don't know. He is the one true God, creator of all. You are worshiping things you made by your hands, but we need to worship the one that made us, that gave us life. There is no thing or person more important than God." He said that God sent His Son Jesus, who died for us and God brought back to life, and that proved that He is the one true God, worthy of our praise. Some of the men of Athens believed, many of them did not, but Paul knew that he had spoken boldly and stood up for God, telling the truth of Jesus, and he had asked them and told them that they needed to be devoted to the one true God with their whole life and their whole heart. I want us to think about the things that keep us from being devoted to God and standing up for Him. Sometimes things in our life become more important to us than God, and we put more time and energy into those things. Sometimes it's getting good grades so people will think we're smart, or being popular so people will like us, or having the best clothes or all the wonderful toys that we love to play with, or doing great in sports. But if we make those things more important to God, it's like making an idol that we make with our own hands, like the Play-Doh or the rocks or the wood. Ask God to help you make Him number one in your life. Ask Him to help you keep Him in that place of loving Him with all your heart and all your soul and all your strength and all your mind, so that you can be devoted to Him and stand up for Him. I want you to treasure God as your one true God. Today's craft is a treasure box because Matthew 6:21 says, "Where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." And we want to love God with all our heart and all our soul and all our strength and all our mind. And this treasure box will help us remember to keep Him number one. So just take a piece of paper and fold it so that you have some more paper below the fold. And curve the edges with some scissors. Cut off the edges in a curve. On the top flap, which is the lid of your box, you're going to make a keyhole and some lines to look like wood for the lid. Under your lid, you're going to want to make a space that's going to be the inside of your box. And I've written that verse from Matthew 6:21, "Where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." And I've put some hearts there to remind me that God should have all my heart and I should treasure Jesus above everything. And then I drew some more wood slats for the bottom of the box. And that's my treasure box to remind me to treasure God as my number one and to love Him with all my heart, soul, strength, and mind. Sing this next song with us that reminds us why He's worthy of our praise and why He's the most important thing and person of all for us to love. It's been great to be with you guys this week. Have a great week and sing this song with us. Bye-bye.